So hey guys, Jonathan Graham here for Guitar Interactive Magazine. NAMM 2020 coverage continues. We are at Hiwatt and we're here with Jordan. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing very well. How are you?
I'm good, man. I'm good to be here and seeing some of these new amps that are coming out from Hiwatt. You want to talk us through what we've got right here?
Sure. So we'll take you through from the top here. We have the Hi 5. This is a brand new, like, sort of lunchbox, 5-watt, all tube, single 12 AX7. It's two channels. One clean, which is kind of like an old school, you know, single volume.
Sure.
You got gain and master on one control. When you get it right up there, you get a little bit of grit out of it. On the other channel, you got gain, independent volume, and gain controls. Mm. Down here, you got like sort of your bluesy hard rock thing. And as you get up, you get a lot more compression, saturation. You can get yourself into like a post rock thing. Really simple two-band EQ, sort of make space for the mids based on where the other controls are. This is really like a plug and play, take it out to a gig, you know, practice, move it around, don't worry about it, kind of setup.
Awesome.
Moving down just one more, we got the Pedalsmith 50. This is basically our new take, a PCB version of our DR504. A couple convenience features that we've added. We've got a linked channel switch here that'll allow you to link the inputs without a jumper cable. We've got a digital reverb on tap, which is kind of spacey. Something, you know, we didn't want to go for a standard spring. We wanted to go for something that's a little bit more modern if you're a pedal player, something that'll fit in. Built-in effects loop, just a lot of convenience features that take that classic sound and bring it forward a little bit into the future for the modern player. Mm-hmm. And then right down here at the very bottom, if you can get that in the shot, we've got the Super High, which is sort of a hot-rodded modified version of our original DR504.
Nice.
Developed in part with Mike Fortin. He's basically put a huge high-gain preamp in front of the original high-watt power section. Mm. It just sounds gnarly. It grinds. Gets everything, four cascading gain stages. I mean, maintains low end, it's tight, it's just everything the modern metal player needs.
Nice one. And with these having the, you know, the PCB options in there, is that meaning the price point's coming in a little better?
Absolutely. What we're thinking, and not exactly finalized yet, but these are all going to be within these two here, at least within the $1,000 range. US. And up here, this is a little lunchbox. She's going for a great deal at $399. And I think they're all, you know, reasonably priced and priced for the average gigging musician or the musician just starting out trying to get his, you know, his first amp and an amp that's going to last him a lifetime.
Awesome.
And give them all the tone they need.
Well, guys, make sure you're checking out Hiwatt's, all the social medias, the website, because it, obviously it's not just these three amps these guys do. You got all your custom stuff that you're doing as well, the British made stuff, and there's tons of it going. But you know what? We've seen the amps. I think it's about time we get to hear a little bit of it. So let's do it.
Sure.